Hey, what's up, guys? My name's a friend, and I figured, you know what? I'm playing on my hardcore Iron Man all the time, and at the same time, it could be like AFKing Nightmare Zone or something, like do really heavily AFKing while I'm making videos. So I thought, why not create a main account? Because I don't have one. The only account that I have is hardcore Iron Man. So, oh, this account is kind of bugged, though. This is a level 12 Herblord without even starting Druidic Ritual. Jagex, don't ban me for bug abuse. I'm gonna complete the quest eventually anyway, but the way I did it is with Botanical Pie, because when they were released, you could boost up plus 4 Herblore, and apparently it didn't check while making potions if you have the quest completed or not, and that allowed some people to get to things like level 2 Herblore, which was not really possible. Anyway, should I just complete the quest? Because I don't know if I can get... I mean, it's a rare account. Maybe I should keep it that way. But the current goal on this account is to try to get some money because I have nothing in the bank. I dropped everything that I had, which was not that much. I think I had like 600 GP from quests or shield of Arav quest completed. And apparently there are people collecting ashes in free to play. So I'm not going to be the only one doing that. All right, let's see. Full inventory of ashes is 756 GP. That's going to be enough though. I just need some basic stuff since I have nothing on me. Wait, actually there's a super anti-poison spawn here. I wonder how much is this? 195. I'm just currently trying to just figure what items I should be collecting to like I don't know, just a random purple dye, which is worth 400 GP now. You have to hop the worlds, which I think it's not going to be a viable method since after you hop 15 worlds, you're going to be logged off for a while. Now, the reason why I bought the axe is because I thought I'm going to chop some regular logs because apparently they're like 50 GP each. So I thought I could make some money, like that would be pretty cool, but then I figured... But when I was playing on my hardcore Iron Man, for some quests you needed planks, so the easiest way to do this is to teleport to Barbarian Outpost and just collect them. So, but I saw a lot of bots collecting these as well. So now I remembered, I was like, maybe this is like a decent money-making method for like early levels. And turns out these are 372 each. Just from one world, I got 1.5k GP. So I want to see how much money I'm going to make from this. I'm going to go ahead and spend half an hour in this place and we're going to see how much. Look at this, full inventory, 10,000 GP already. Like I'm very close to buying my first rune item, even if I can't equip it, but still a lot of money. Yo, look, this is like a new account, you know, fresh account, has had nothing on it. Look at this, 83,000 worth of planks in half an hour that I collected without any kind of skills. You can literally teleport here with a game's necklace. No magic level required for that. Now, because I don't have a Varrok teleport, I'm going to be using this guy to teleport to Security Stronghold. I think this is like one-time thing, like you cannot use it multiple times, but yeah, it's closer than from Lumbridge. Man, there's something wrong with these planks because they're not selling even for like 10% less. Like I literally double clicked on that 5% thing and it's been like half an hour that I've been trying to sell these. So I'm gonna go and try it for like 300. It's not as much. Not as much as it was shown, but it's still 67k. However, now I want to try another money-making method. And I'm going to spend some money on Ring of Wealth because I want to have that teleport straight to Grand Exchange. And if you run out of charges, it's like 1,000 cheaper that you can sell it for. So 5 teleports for 1,000, it's much cheaper than just buying Varrok teleports. Well, this is exactly what I was talking about, because when I was trying these money making methods on my main account, I was using stamina potions. I had all kinds of stats. I didn't even realize that to pass this log you need level 20 agility. Oh, may I actually have some trouble against these giant bats though. So just got 20 agility, but these guys should be, you see these guys are attacking. I remember hardcore Iron Man died here because he was teleported to a random event. And when he came back from random event, he just died to these bats. By the way, this is the map. This is where I am at the moment. And I know that I've done this method before. I think I showed in one of the videos, but I want to try this again because it seems like a very free way to make money. Look how quickly he gave this challenge and it's like 825 GP. Now, the question will be if I can sell it, but I just want to see how it compares to planks. Half an hour, let's see how much money I can make from this. The timer is currently at 2 minutes only, and look at this, 21,000 in my inventory, just like that. That's why I took the teleports, by the way, because it's like much closer to teleport to. Now, this, my friends, was much, much better than the planks. It shows 177k during the same amount of time, except that I had to level up agility. But if I already had one... It's like triple money pretty much, if I can sell it. So I'm going to go ahead for medium price, put these on. Of course. You know what? I'm going to, for now, just going to leave it as it is. But I was looking at bucket of sand. Like I'm going to fill buckets with sand. Maybe that's going to be like good money making method. But then I noticed there was a bucket of wax that was going for 552 GP. Oh, that's kind of interesting. A beekeeper and anem event near the beehives. This is where the beehives are located, near the flax fields, near the Sears village. And if you try to take it just regularly, you will be hit by... Oh, actually, I used the repellent already. But normally, if you try to use it, you will get hit by 2 damage. The way to get buckets of wax is by using the insect repellent on this and then using a bucket. However, you have to do this every time. So one time an insect repellent, one time bucket of... So if you get into normal rhythm, it's fairly easy. As you can see, my inventory is filling up fairly... I think because I already did 2 trips. I think they take like 1 minute for the full inventory. I would say this sounds pretty weird, but this is like pretty good method of obtaining money, especially since, again, you barely need any starting money. You just have to buy like a few buckets and just fill it in. Hey, what's up, guys? This is me from the future. As I was editing this video, I said it takes 1 minute to fill full inventory of wax. Turns out it's actually half a minute to get 14K. That's right. Although it does take some time to get to the bank, especially if your agility level is low, but this is surprisingly such a fast way to make money. Can someone spot me 100K? Man, these guys, you don't need that. You just go like, you know, I don't think this method is going to work eventually because, I mean, nobody needs, why would anyone needs like, especially if there are thousands and thousands coming in Grand Exchange eventually. But it shows 268K, but... Can I sell them? Of course they're not selling. God damn it. Why do I pick the worst items to sell? What about this one, actually? Maybe you could call. Hey, 200. You could, but you need Hop Worlds. This is completely not viable. This is also not selling. Nothing is selling. Oh, no. Oh, just bought one. Actually, maybe I could leave it. Yo, what's up, guys? I just woke up, and this is the next day for me. And what happened with Bucket of Wax is that it was selling, but only one. Like, maybe every 2 to 5 minutes, somebody who's doing quests would buy one, and eventually, overnight, yes, I had to wait for this, but overnight, I sold for 488 each. This is how much I made in half an hour by just collecting this. Now, I'm just saying this is not gonna work if a lot of people are gonna be doing this. But this is the method that I used to do. Now, this also sold, apparently this boosts crafting or something by plus one. So maybe these are actually in demand by some people. But yeah, this is, this is not all. I still have some money in the bank. Look at this, 358K made in what? An hour and a half, if you don't count agility training. If I want to try to buy diamond bones, 100. Oh no, it's only 100. Oh my god, that's the whole cash that gone. So it looks like I have enough money. And I do actually, if I want to buy gear, that is really enough money for gear, but not something like. I just wanted to buy some quick prayer XP. Are you serious? Somehow I looked up the obby cape, like, because I was like trying to equip myself, like, with everything. Whoa, hold up. 1 million for obby cape? And I think it's just like old players coming back into the game because of mobile, and they're like, oh yeah, yeah, remember back in the day, the obby cape and stuff? I think it's still the best buyable cape though in the game. Wait, let's see if you can still make potions without completing the druidic ritual quest. And you can. Ooh. I mean, I don't think there's any advantages, to be honest. It's just the quest not completed. Dude, I don't get what's wrong with these guys. Like, this guy was training here the whole time. You can see his loot, right? So he has like plenty of stuff. I'm just taking one crab, right? One crab I'm taking, like, low level. Look at me. I'm just training my defense because these guys apparently are hitting a little bit. This guy just comes here, doesn't say anything. He's like, you know what? Hey, I'm going to manually. You know what? Manually. No, no, you're not in this world. What? It's one crab spawn. One crab. Man, some people are just, I don't understand. Like, look around you. Look everywhere. Should I go in some corner? Oh, that's a one crab. That's one crab spawn. I'm just going to take this one. Oh boy, you know he's watching me. Oh boy, you know he's watching me right now. He's like, oh, I'm going to snatch this crab from you. He's coming closer, a little bit closer, right? Finish this crab off. He's going to be on to me.
I told you.
Do you see what I mean? What are these guys doing? I swear, I hopped so many worlds. This is like the worst place in RuneScape. I thought it was Grand Exchange. That was the worst. No, it's the crabs. You go to crabs that are like... There was a guy with black dragonhide using broad bolts to kill crabs. Are you kidding me? No, he doesn't like me. No, don't take my one crab, man. Ah. God damn it. Okay, this is gonna be the end of the video. Thank you guys for watching this video. I'm gonna have to go to Grand Exchange anyway to upgrade my gear, because these guys are hitting a little bit, you know, get some black armor, maybe get some better weapon.